Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to my latest model train and rolling stock review video. As you might see, I'm going to review the Hornby Mark III DVT that was announced in 2009, but unfortunately, due to production delays, it didn't hit the shelves till 2010, which would be early 2010. This one is the Mark III DVT driving van trailer, also known as the driving luggage vehicle, which could be also translated as DLV. This one is 82,119, and the price of the Mark III DVT cost me £45 from Trains for You, as I bought this in 2010. For those of you that want to see it running, there is some videos on my channel of it actually being ran on some of my friends' layouts, as well as at Railworld with the Dreamliner train. But this review is going to cover the Mark III DVT in general and its features. So, just for the note, the reference number is R4396. For those of you that want to order one for your collection. The model is very well detailed. It comes with directional lighting and it is DCC ready as well. Also comes in like a plastic tray, similar to how the Backman new rolling stock comes, like the Class 150, which I will do a video of in closer detail at a later date. So, let's take it out of its packaging. Let's have a closer look at the model. In the box, there is some instructions in there, and there's a sachet which comes with some extra brake pipes, which you can fit to the end of the driving van trailer, if desired. But upon removing the tray, removing the DVT from its plastic tray, we have a very nice, stunning replica of the British Rail Mark III DVT. Originally introduced to traffic in 1988, which eliminated the need for locomotives running round on the West Coast Main Line intercity sets. The model does have head and tail lights, and I think, yep, the buffers are also sprung as well. The model even has an 8-pin DCC socket, which enables you to control the lights under DCC mode. As you can see, you've got a dummy screw link coupling there. You've got a jumper lead socket mounted here. And you've also got another cable and an electrical jumper lead on this side as well. So, again, top marks for Hornby, as they have given us yet another cracking model. Very superb piece of work, if you ask me. Upon looking at the other end of the model, if you just turn it round, you've even got the accurately modelled corridor, which is, this is made of a PVC rubber, which looks a lot better than the moulded plastic corridors like you get on their current Mark III carriages. Perhaps they may produce some matching high quality Mark III carriages to match the DVT, which in my view would be a very nice addition. You've got the overhead catenary warning signs on the sides, just adjacent to the corridor connection, there and there. You've also got the classification plate, which includes the maximum permissible top speed, which on the West Coast main line, these Mark III DVTs can only run at no more than 110 miles per hour. Or in metric terms, that would be 177 kilometers per hour. Like on the front, oh no. My mistake, unfortunately, the buffers on the back of the Mark III DVT are not sprung. These are fixed on my version of the Mark III DVT anyway. You do have an NEM coupler, but I think that actually comes out if you want it to fit like a bar coupler to your Mark III rake to make it fixed. And also you've got the extra details such as the etched handrails. And also, what I like about this model is the door actually opens on the driver's cab as well. Both sides of the Mark III DVT, both of the driver cab doors do open, this one and that one as well, which in my mind, considering it's a non-powered vehicle, like the prototypes, as they're not powered anyway, this is one of the best ready to run rolling stock models that Hornby have brought out so far. I do have another one of these Mark III DVTs in Virgin Trains livery, although I've chosen to review the one Anglia one, as my Virgin Trains version has become a bit of a celebrity on my channel already. Well, that concludes my review. My final score for the Mark III DVT, I'm going to give it a 10 out of 10. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to post them in the comment section below, and have a good week. Once again, thank you for watching.